Well, we made it through the official school year. Graduation was last Saturday. It was a long event for some of us, but what I heard from the community and from the families is that they really appreciated the fact that it was not a long event for each one of them. I think the most beautiful part about graduation was seeing the families and the students able to be together there on the field while the students got their diploma, and afterwards to see the celebration that was immediate and personal. We saw some things in graduation this year that we would like to try and continue. That individual, personalized piece, we would like to find a way to continue to do that. We would like to continue the graduation parade through town like we did last Saturday evening, because the town was just, I can't describe it any other way than it was just electric with celebration. That's worth continuing. But there are some pieces that we don't want to lose also, because the grandeur of the students walking in and seeing all of them together, that's just a moment that has a tendency to kind of burn itself into our memories. So we're going to continue to work on making graduation in Swain County for our seniors the most amazing event as we possibly can. And one of the reasons for that is because the next school year is also going to have an emphasis that we're going to call hashtag DevilGrad. We'll talk to you more about that, but we as a community need to come together and help everyone understand that finishing high school, graduating with that diploma, is incredibly important so that our students can be fully prepared to move into the next stage of their life. We'll be talking to you about that, and we'll be actually asking for you to commit with us to making hashtag DevilGrad become something that is very important in Swain County. Speaking of moving into the next phases, I want to say one more time to our graduates for 2020. You have been the most amazing class. You have endured things that no other class has ever experienced. All the way from when you were born in the 9/11 era and as you have moved through school. It seems that your class has moved through the schools at exactly the time that we've had little crises or even major crises in America. Thank you for being so resilient. Thank you for being so encouraging in so many ways. And as I said to several of you on Saturday at graduation, I truly look forward to seeing what your future holds, because this class is going to do great things. I think we have already seen that that is a very, very real part of who you are. We're moving forward in Swain County. The 2019-2020 school year is over. We're looking at 2020-2021. Yesterday, we received information from the Department of Public Instruction, the Department of Health and Human Services, from the Governor's Office. All of those groups have come together and given us guidance for what the beginning of our next school year could possibly look like. There are three plans. One of the plans is for all of the students to come back, and we have everyone in the classrooms kind of like we have had in the past, with some additional safety guidelines mixed into that. Another one is a mixed opportunity for being in class and having remote learning. And then the third option is remote learning, which would be kind of like what we have experienced in this past spring, but it would be on steroids a little more, and there would be a little more expectation. I will tell you that my personal preference, and I believe our preference here in the school system, is for that first plan. We want our students, your sons and daughters, the students of Swain County, to be back in the classroom on August the 17th. And that's my intent. However, everyone has to understand that we live within the guidelines and the boundaries that are given to us by our leadership in Raleigh. We will do everything that we can to do three things. Number one, make sure that the students are safe and that they're well taken care of. Number two, take care of our staff, because without our staff, there's not a whole lot that we can do. And number three, get the kids back in the classroom as soon as we can. You have my commitment on those three points. We will be bringing to you more information about that through the summer as we work through those plans. So I would hope that you would perhaps subscribe to the Maroon Devil Network if you haven't already. And I think it's going to be very important for you to do that, because we are probably going to dial back our weekly messages to every other week through the summer, because there's going to be some vacation times and some things like that. And we've got a lot of planning that we need to put in place that we might not be able to have completed on a weekly basis. So please subscribe to the Maroon Devil Network. That way you'll get notifications as we bring information to you. And also you'll be able to see some other things that we might be posting by video. For example, our staff has put together an end of the year celebration digitally, and we want to share that with you. And I think that that might be uploaded either this evening or tomorrow at some point. But you won't know if you don't subscribe. So for now, at the end of the school year, I want to put out a great big thank you to all of you, because you have been so supportive of all that we have gone through this school year. And it has been challenging for us, but for me, it has been totally worthwhile to work with you. So thank you from the bottom of my heart. I hope that you all have a great summer season. I encourage you to stay safe, to stay healthy, and I also encourage you to continue to follow along with us as we begin our planning phase now. So until the next time we're together, God bless you. Thank you for being part of our Swain family, and I look forward to bringing you news very soon.